Hello everyone, myself Dr. Anuradha Sharma, and today we will discuss 50 most expected questions of biology with complete explanation. This series will be important for your upcoming NEET 2021. So here comes the first question. Corpus gland Corpus gland are found in female amphibians, female mammals and male amphibians. Now we know that these corpus gland, they are found in male mammals, and these corpus gland are also known as bulbourethral gland. Now these are exocrine glands and they are found mainly in male reproductive system. They are located at the inferior to the prostate gland and lateral to urethra in the urogenital diaphragm. So these corpus gland are found in male mammals. So option B is the correct answer. Next question is, which one of the following is related to ex situ conservation of threatened animals and plants? First option is biodiversity hotspot. Second is Amazon rainforest. Third is Himalayan region. And fourth is wildlife safari parks. Now, what is this ex situ conservation? This ex situ conservation is a conservation of selected area or threatened animals and plants in the environment which is outside the natural homes. It includes various botanical gardens, zoological parks, wildlife parks and gene banks. So option D is the correct answer. Next question is, the test tube baby means fertilization and development both in uterus, fertilization in vitro and then transplantation in uterus, a baby grown in test tube, and last option is fertilize and develop embryo in the test tube. Now first of all, we should understand what is this test tube baby means. Test tube baby means fertilization which is done in vitro, which means that fertilization is done outside the body. So fertilization is mainly done outside the body, that is fertilization is done in a test tube. So in test tube there is fertilization of the male sperm and female ova, and further this zygote is transplanted into the mother's uterus. And after that, it grows into a child. So this is test tube baby. So option B, that is fertilization in vitro and then transplantation in uterus, is the correct answer. Now next question is, in history of biology, Human Genome Project led to the development of biotechnology, biomonitoring, bioinformatics and last is biosystematics. Now we know that Human Genome Project is a project which is concerned with the mapping of DNA sequences and its also alignment of DNA. So this is done with the help of computer knowledge and which is known as bioinformatics. So option C is the correct answer, that is bioinformatics. Now next question is, spermiation is a process of release of sperm from seminiferous tubule, vas deferens, epididymis and prostate gland. First of all, we should understand what is this spermiation process. It is a process of release of spermatozoa from the Sertoli cells and then they passes to the cavity of seminiferous tubule, and from here the sperm passes through vas deferentia and enters the epididymis. So this spermiation, it is a process of release of sperm from seminiferous tubule. So option A is the correct answer. Next question is, the figure below shows the steps of three steps A, B, C of PCR, select the option corresponding to the. So we know that PCR it is polymerase chain reaction. So option C, that is extension in presence of three stable DNA polymerase, is the correct answer. Now we know that PCR it is a technique which is used to amplify DNA, and this is commonly used in various medical and biological research labs. And in this there are many steps, like first is the denaturation at a particular temperature, that is 94 degree centigrade to 98 degree centigrade. B step is annealing, that is binding of DNA primer to the separated strand. And third is the extension of this elongated strand using DNA primer and with heat stable DNA polymerase. So these are the steps. So option C is the correct answer. Next question is, the process of translation is ribosome synthesis, protein synthesis, DNA synthesis, and last is RNA synthesis. Now we know that the process of translation is protein synthesis. So from mRNA it is converted into this protein, and this process is known as translation. So option B is the correct answer. Next question is, origin of species was written by Oparin, Weismann, Lamarck and Darwin. This Darwin scientist published his observation in a book which is known as Origin of Species, and it was published in 1859. Darwin, in his book, this book was very popular and it changed people thinking about organic evolution. So option D is the correct answer, that is Darwin. Now next question is, Vidal test, it is used for the diagnosis of malaria, pneumonia, tuberculosis or typhoid. Now we know that Vidal test, it was developed by G.F.I. Vidal, and it is an agglutination test which is used for or to detect the presence of antibodies. So this test is used for the diagnosis of typhoid. Next question is, which of the following is not a sexually transmitted disease? Trichomoniasis, elephantiasis, syphilis or acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Now we know that this elephantiasis, it is the inflammation of brain. This elephantiasis, it is mostly caused by mild flu-like signs, and symptoms are fever and headache. So option B is the correct answer. This elephantiasis, it is not a sexually transmitted disease. Next question is, the label of herbarium sheet does not carry information on the date of collection, name of collector, local names, and last is height of plant. Now first of all, we should understand what is this herbarium. This herbarium is a collection of plants which have been dried, pressed and mounted, and they are pasted on a white sheet of paper, white file. So basically the following information are present on the herbarium file, that is the scientific name of the plant, common name, family, locality, date of collection, name of the collector, plant characteristic and name of institution. So this height of the plant is not present in the herbarium file. Next question is, in Begonia, thorns or modifications of adventitious root, stem, leaf or stipules. Now in bougainvillea plant we know that thorns are the modification into stem, and this is used for support. So option B is the correct answer. Next question is, one set of plant was grown at 12 hours day and 12 hours night period cycle, and it flowered, while other set of night phase was interrupted by a flash of light and it did not produce the flower. Under which of one of the following categories will you place this plant? First option is long day plant, second is darkness in neutral, third is day neutral plant, and last is short day plant. Now we know that short day plants, they require long interrupted dark periods for flowering, and they will not produce any flower if night is interrupted by a flash of light. So option D is the correct answer, that is short day plant. Next question is, stems modified into flat green organs performing the functions of leaf are known as phyllocladids, scales, clathodes and phyllodes. Now we know that phyllocladids, these are the flattened green stems, and they have been taken, they are responsible for the function of photosynthesis. While these clathodes, they are only branches of stem that are modified to take over the function of leaves. These clathodes, they may be flattened and they are spiny in structure. So first option is the correct answer, that is phyllocladids. Next question is, what is true about all sponges without exception? First is, they are all marine. Second, they have flagellated collar cells. Third, they have mixed skeleton consisting of spicules and spongin fibers. And fourth is, they reproduce only asexually by budding. Now we know that these sponges, they are marine with exception of spongidae, and members of which occur in freshwater, that is spongula. So this B option is the correct answer, that is they have flagellated collar bones and they reproduce by fragmentation. These sponges also exhibit sexual reproduction. Next question is, connecting link between glycolysis and Krebs cycle before entering the Krebs cycle, pyruvate is changed to oxaloacetate, PEP, pyruvate or acetyl coenzyme A. Now we know that end product of Krebs cycle is pyruvate, and this pyruvate enters the mitochondria and it is converted into acetyl coenzyme A. So this acetyl coenzyme A is the product formed before entering the Krebs cycle. So option D is the correct answer. Next question is, root hairs develop from region of elongation, root cap, meristematic activity or maturation. Now we know that root hairs, they are lateral tubular outgrowths, and they develop from the outer cells of zone of maturation. So option D is the correct answer, that is maturation. Next question is, the morphological nature of edible part of coconut is cotyledons, endosperm, pericarp or perisperm. Now we know that morphological nature of edible part of coconut is endosperm. So option B is the correct answer. Next question is, Casparian strips occur in epidermis, pericycle, cortex or endodermis. Now these Casparian strips, they are band of thickening present on the radial and tangential walls of the endodermis, and it is made up of seborrheic and lignin. So option D is the correct answer, that is endodermis. Now, next question is, fetal sex can be determined by examining cells from the amniotic fluid by looking for chiasmata, kinetochore, bar bodies or sex chromosome. Now, we know that these bar bodies are structure that consist of X chromosome and these are found in non-dividing nuclei of female mammals. This amniotic fluid, it is found in the fetus and this amniotic fluid, it protects the fetus from various shocks. The presence of bar body indicates that the developing fetus is female with two X chromosomes. So this bar body is used for sex determination. Now next question is, in Bt cotton, the Bt toxin present in plant tissue as prototoxin is converted into active toxin due to first action of gut microorganism, second is presence of conversion factors in insect gut, third is alkaline pH of insect gut and fourth is acidic pH of the insect gut. Now we know that this Bacillus thuringiensis, it produces proteins and these proteins kill certain insects and this Bacillus thuringiensis, it forms the protein crystals. Now these crystals contain a toxic insecticidal protein and this toxin does not kill the bacillus because it exists in inactive form, but when it goes into the alimentary canal, due to the alkaline pH, it is activated and it binds to the surface of the midgut of epithelial cells and create pores and cause swelling and lysis of the insect. So this option C is the correct answer, that is alkaline pH of the insect gut. Next question is, the balloon shaped structure called as tyrosis first originate in the lumen of vessels, second characterize the sapwood, third are extension of xylem parenchyma cells into vessels and fourth are linked to the ascent sap through xylem vessels. Now what are these tyroses? These tyroses are balloon-like structure and they are extension of parenchyma that produce into the lumen of neighboring xylem vessels or tracheas through a pit in the cell wall. These tyroses, they are mostly common in older woody tissues and are responsible possibly for injury or block of vessels and thus they prevent the entry of fungi and other pathogens. So option C is the correct answer, that is these tyroses are extensions of xylem parenchyma into vessels. Next question is, a particular species of plant produces light non-sticky pollen in large number and its stigma are long and feathery. These modifications facilitated pollination by insects, wind, water and animals. Now we know that plants use two types of agents. One is abiotic agent and second is biotic agent. Now abiotic agent is wind and water and biotic agent is animals. So pollination occurs basically with the help of abiotic and biotic agents. Now we know that wind pollination is very common among abiotic agents and they often consist of the plants which are pollinated by wind, they often consist of well exposed stamens and these pollens are easily dispersed into the wind current. So option C is the correct answer, that is wind. Next question is, in male cockroaches, sperms are stored in which part of reproductive system? Seminal vesicles, mushroom glands, testes and vas deferens. Now we know that seminal vesicles, they are numerous small sacs which are present on ventral surface of the interior part of ejaculatory duct and they store the sperms. So option A is the correct answer, that is seminal vesicles. Next question is, names of Sheddin and Son are associated with first protoplasm as physical basis of life, second is cell theory, third is theory of cell lineages, and fourth is nucleus function as control center of the cell. Now, this Sheddin and Son, they are associated with the cell theory. And they gave the cell theory in 1839. Now, according to this theory, all the living cells are composed of the pre-existing cells. Cell theory, it is also known as cell principle. So, option B is the correct answer, that is cell theory. Next question is, which is the method of sterilization in which a small part of fallopian tube is removed or tied up? Third is ovary are removed surgically. Third option is small part of vas deferens is removed. And fourth is uterus is removed surgically. Now, this is tubectomy. So, we know that tubectomy, it involves the blocking of the fallopian tube. A small part of the fallopian tube, it is removed and it is further tied through a small incision and so that there will be no fertilization. So, tubectomy is a method of sterilization in which a small part of fallopian tube, it is removed or tied up. Next question is, according to Munsch theory, the cause of flow of soluble substances, first protoplasmic flow, second is mass flow due to reduction of turgor pressure, third is diffusion, and fourth is none of these. Now, according to this Munsch flow theory, it is based on the difference in the osmotic pressure in leaf mesophyll cells and root cells. So, option B is the correct answer, that is mass flow due to reduction of turgor pressure. Next question is, Alexander von Humboldt described for the first time the laws of limiting factor, species area relationship, population growth equation, and ecological biodiversity. Now, this Alexander Humboldt described the species area relationship for the first time. So, option B is the correct answer. Next question is, the chemoosmotic coupling hypothesis of oxidative phosphorylation proposed that adenosine triphosphate is formed because of high energy bonds in mitochondrial proteins, ADP is pumped out of matrix, a proton gradient forms across the inner membrane, and there is change in the permeability of inner mitochondrial membrane. So this chemoosmotic theory, it was published by British biochemist Peter Michell to explain the formation of ATP in the mitochondrial electron transport chain. So option C is the correct answer, that is a proton gradient is formed across the inner membrane. Next question is, the eukaryotic genome differs from the prokaryotic genome because first the DNA is complex with histone in prokaryotes, next the DNA is circular and single-stranded in prokaryotes, third repetitive sequences are present in eukaryotes, and fourth is the genes in the former case are organized into operons. So B is the correct answer, that is the DNA is circular and it is single-stranded in prokaryotes. Next question is, the TAC polymerase enzyme is obtained from Bacillus subtilis, Pseudomonas putida, Thermus aquaticus, and Thiobacillus ferrandus. Now we know that this TAC enzyme, it is used in PCR to amplify the DNA segments. And this enzyme is isolated from thermophilic bacterium, that is Thermus aquaticus. Next question is, the enzyme recombinase is required at which stage of meiosis? Picotine, zygotine, diplotene and diagnosis. Now this picotine, this stage is characterized by appearance of recombination nodules at the site of which crossing over occurs between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome. Now these nodules, they contain multi-enzyme complex which is known as this recombinase. So first option is the correct answer, that is picotine. Next question is, which of the following is incorrect regarding vasectomy? No sperm occurs in seminal fluid, no sperm occurs in epididymis, vasa deferentia is cut and tied, and irreversible sterility. Now what is this vasectomy? Vasectomy, it is surgical contraception and it is a method which is used mainly in males. Now in this vasectomy, a small part of vas deferens is removed and it is tied up and small cut is done at on the scrotum. Now this prevents the entry of sperm into the fallopian tube. So it prevents finally fertilization. Next question is, which one of the following statement is not true about somatic embryogenesis? First, a somatic embryo develops into a somatic cell. Second, the pattern of development of somatic embryo is comparable to that of zygote embryo. Third, somatic embryos can develop from microspores. And fourth, this somatic embryo is induced by auxin-24D. Now, this somatic embryogenesis, it is basically a process where plant or embryo is dividing and it forms a single somatic cell or a group of somatic cell. So option C is the correct answer, that is somatic embryos can develop from microspores. Now next question is, select the correct route for passage of sperms in male frog. First is testes to vas deferentia, kidney, seminal vesicle, urogenital tract and cloaca. Second is vas testes to vas deferentia, Bidder's canal, ureter, cloaca. And third is testes to vas deferentia, kidney, bladder, canal, urogenital tract and cloaca. So we know that the correct route is from testes to vas deferentia, kidney, Bidder's canal, urogenital tract and cloaca. So option C is the correct answer. Next question is, which of the following is a pair of viral disease? Common cold and AIDS, dysentery and common cold, typhoid and tuberculosis, ringworm and AIDS. Now we know that common cold and AIDS, these are the viral disease. And common cold, it is mainly caused by rhinovirus. And AIDS, we know it is caused by HIV virus. So these both are the viral disease, that is common cold and AIDS. Next question is, identify the wrong statement in contrast to heartwood. First, it is highly durable. Second, it conducts water and minerals sufficiently. Third, it comprises dead elements. And fourth, organic compounds are deposited in it. Now this heartwood, we know it is a non-functional part of secondary xylem and hence it does not conduct the water and minerals. So option B is the correct answer, that is it conducts water and minerals efficiency. So it is the wrong answer. We have to identify the wrong statement. Next question is, one child is hemophilic, while its paternal twin brother is normal. Which one of the following information is most appropriate? The mother must be heterozygous, the child is monozygotic twin, the other child is female and father is hemophilic, and last is hemophilic child is male. Now we know that the mother must be hemophilic carrier and one of the twins would have inherited the normal X chromosome and other would have received the X chromosome carrying the gene of hemophilia. So option A is the correct answer, that is mother must have been heterozygotic. Next question is, what is the correct about cell theory in view of current status of knowledge? First, it needs modification due to discovery of subcellular structures like chloroplast and mitochondria. Second, modified cell theory means that all living cells are composed of cells capable of reproducing. Third, cell theory does not hold good because of the living beings. And fourth, cell theory means all living objects consist of cell, whether or not they are capable of reproducing. Now we know that the exception to cell theory are viruses, which do not possess a cellular machinery. They consist of DNA or RNA core and they are surrounded by a protein sheath and they lack the cellular organization. So option C is the correct answer. Now next question is, which classical model proposed by Watson and Crick is represented by this figure? Now we know that this figure is represented the replication, and we know that replication is semi-conservative. So this figure represents the semi-conservative DNA replication. Next question is, which of the following cellular parts is correctly described? Centrioles, sites for active RNA synthesis, lysosomes, thylakoids, flattened membrane sacs forming the grana of chloroplast, and ribosomes. These are chloroplast, larger 80 units. Now we know that third option, that is thylakoids, they are flattened membrane sacs forming the grana of chloroplast. It is correctly matched option. Next question is, which one of the following cellular part is correctly described? First, centriole, sites for active RNA synthesis. This question we have already done. Next question is, nucleotides are the building blocks for nucleic acid. Each nucleotide is composed molecule formed by base and sugar phosphate, base sugar and OH group, base sugar phosphate and sugar phosphate. Now we know that nucleotide has three distinct units. First is a phosphate group, which is derived from phosphoric acid, a pentose sugar, and a ring-shaped nitrogenous base. And nucleoside plus phosphoric acid, it forms the nucleotide plus water. So first option, that is base sugar phosphate, is the correct answer. Now next question is, the osmotic expansion of a cell kept in water is chiefly regulated by mitochondria, vacuoles, plastids or ribosome. Now we know that vacuole, it is a single membrane. It is bounded by single membrane, which is known as tonoplast. And the function of tonoplast is it is semi-permeable. So it segregates all the vacuolar contents from the cytoplasm and allows the osmotic entry of water and stores various nutrients. So option B is the correct answer, that is vacuoles. Next question is, organic substance bound to an enzyme and essential for activity is isozyme, coenzyme, holoenzyme or apoenzyme. Now we know that enzymes, they are very simple, and these enzymes are made up of proteins like pepsin and amylase. While conjugate enzymes, they have additional non-protein factor which may be organic or inorganic. Now loosely attach organic factor. Loosely attach organic factor. It is known as the cofactor or coenzyme. So option B is the correct answer, that is coenzyme. Now next question is, which one of the following structure is an organelle within an organelle? First is ribosome, second is peroxisome, third is endoplasmic reticulum, and fourth is mesosome. Now we know that these ribosomes, they are small naked non-membranous bound particles, and they are mainly formed of RNA plus proteins. Ribosomes are also seen as organelles like mitochondria and chloroplast, and so this ribosome is known as an organelle within the organ. Now next question is, embryo sac is to ovule as dash is to anther, stamen, filament, pollen grains and endosium. Now we know that pollen grains, they are male gametophyte, and as the anthers dehiscence and matures, the microspores dissociate from each other and they develop into these pollen grains. So embryo sac is to ovules as pollen grain is to anther. So pollen grain is the correct answer. Next question is, puberty occurs in female at an age of 8 to 10 years, 11 to 14 years, 15 to 17 years and 18 to 20 years. Now we know that puberty, it generally occurs in girls at an age of 11 to 14 years. Next question is, phenetic classification is based on first sexual characteristic, the ancestral lineage of existing organism, observable characteristic of existing organism and dendrograms based on DNA characteristic. Now we know that phenetic classification, it is based on observable characteristic of existing organism. Next question is, satellite DNA is useful tool in organ transplantation, sex determination, forensic science and genetic engineering. Now we know that this satellite DNA, it is widely used in forensic science and it is also used in DNA fingerprinting, which is used to find criminals and paternal differences. So option C is the correct answer, that is forensic science. Next question is, select the option which is not correct with respect to enzyme action. First is, substrate binds to enzyme at active site. Addition of a lot of succinate does not reverse the inhibition of succinate dehydrogenase by malonate. A non-competitive inhibitor binds to enzyme at a site distinct from which it binds to the substrate. And fourth is, malonate is a competitive inhibitor of succinate dehydrogenase. So we know that option D is not correct, that malonate is a competitive inhibitor of succinate dehydrogenase. Next question is, a column of water within xylem vessel of tall trees does not break its weight because tensile strength of water, lignification, positive root pressure and fourth is dissolved sugar in water. Now first is the correct answer, that is it does not break due to tensile strength of water. So please press the bell icon and subscribe my channel so that we can bring more videos for your revision of upcoming NEET 2021.